He's the vice chair of the Democratic National Committee, a former White House aide under President Obama. Michael, according to an NBC Wall Street Journal poll, more people trust Democrats to handle health care than they do the Republicans. But we've seen Democrats losing some key special elections lately. What do they have to do to capitalize on this trust?
Boris, great question and great to be with you. Well, first, let's be clear. You know, our party, the Democratic Party, is fighting to create more access and opportunity as it relates to health care. All we're seeing from the Trump-Pence-Ryan agenda is taking health care away, and Mitch McConnell is obviously doubling down on that. You know, when you think about 23 million Americans will lose access to health care, that is not what we should be doing at all. As elected officials, we should be helping people, not hurting people. And when we see the Congressional Budget Office will be scoring the bill on Monday and a vote bill coming out on next Thursday, that's why at least five Republicans said thus far they can't vote for this bill. Now, as it relates to the special elections, let's be clear. These are districts that are in very deep red seats. For context, in 2009, when we had special elections under President Obama, we won all five seats. We didn't lose our first one until May 2010. And so when you talk about seats that in the Ossoff race, you lose by four, and in the Archie Parnell race, you lose by three, that's showing incredible progress. There are 71 districts, Boris, that have better Democratic numbers than the Ossoff race did. And so we're making incredible strides and progress. The fact that the Republicans are competing in these seats is a reminder that we are the ones fighting for opportunity for all while they're fighting for the top 1%.
Now, Michael, I have to ask you about this explosive report in the Washington Post claiming that President Obama knew about Vladimir Putin's direct hacking orders of the 2016 election, and specifically this quote from one former Obama administration official saying that it's the hardest thing for them to defend in their time in the administration, saying that I feel like we sort of choked. Do you believe the Obama administration choked?
Absolutely not. When you look at and read the report, it conveys that President Obama took actions, whether it be economic sanctions, the closing of Russian offices, sending out Russian diplomats and sending them back to Russia. So actions were taken. And it also conveyed in the report, Boris, that the reason why he was mindful is he didn't want to seem like you were leaning towards one side and one party in that manner, and people feeling like you're trying to tilt an election in that manner. So trying to be responsible and appropriate in leadership, which is exactly what we're not seeing from Donald Trump. When you have Donald Trump conveying in a tweet that nothing happened, well, one, we know that's just a lie. That's just completely not accurate. Number two, Donald Trump and the Trump administration has been conveying, well, they have been following the Russian attacks on the election. Well, how are you sitting silent and idling by right now? And then thirdly, when you think about what's been happening, when you see the continued reports that in these closed Senate sessions that apparently Trump has been communicating to the National Security officers in different aspects, and obviously former Director Comey, to try to get rid of the Russian investigation, it shows what was really at stake. You had President Obama that was taking actions, and obviously more could always be taken, versus Donald Trump, who is just sitting on the sidelines just trying to protect themselves. So again, let's be clear on what we're saying here. We are taking actions. The Democratic Party is taking actions. The Democratic Party is showing leadership. Donald Trump is sitting on the sidelines and clearly just trying to help protect himself and protect those at the top 1%. And that's the reason why we have to continue these investigations, while we cannot sit idly by, and make sure we get to the bottom of what's happening as it relates to Russia and trying to interfere with our elections.
Michael, I do have to ask you about another portion of that report, though, that says in no uncertain terms that there was a sense within the Obama administration that Hillary Clinton was going to win the election, and that led to a lack of urgency. What do you make of that specific piece of the report?
Well, you know, none of us can obviously comment fully on what may be in the information itself, but let's convey this. You know, I think essentially 99.9% of people externally and internally in different aspects were presuming that Hillary Clinton was going to win. Obviously, all the polls were indicating it as such. But the critical question is, what did you do with that information? And it, as the report indicates, President Obama took actions, and actions were moving forward. However, in the reverse, what we're seeing with Donald Trump right now is literally ignoring what are the clear facts of 17 intelligent agencies saying that Russians hacked into elections, had impact on the elections, had impact on the state electoral colleges, the state electoral systems, rather. And moving forward, he's essentially saying, well, we should just move on as if nothing is happening. And so we are recognizing the information and we're making progress on what's happening here, but let's make sure we're staying focused on what's happening today. How are we being united as a party? How are we uniting as a Democratic Party so we can move forward and make sure we're communicating to people people from the school board to the Senate, from the city council to Congress, from the state house to the White House, how we're building up a party and moving forward, versus just talking about what happened in 2016 and not trying to have progress as we're seeing on the other side. The reality is you're going to have a vote coming up next week where 23 million Americans could potentially lose their health care. They want to know, what are we doing for them? The Democratic Party is fighting for them. The question is, what is the Republican Party doing for them?
Well, there's a lot of questions, especially this week, about the cohesiveness of the Democratic Party, with some Democratic lawmakers calling for Nancy Pelosi, the leader of the House, to move aside because she's, according to some, including the president, helping Republicans win races. Do you think she's toxic for Democrats?
Absolutely not. No. So Donald Trump communicating what he believes, you know, let's just make sure he stays focused on the facts. This is the same one who said he supposedly had tapes and all of a sudden he didn't have tapes. So his tweets can speak for themselves. Nonetheless, when we think about our party, you know, again, we have to be clear. We're talking about deep red seats. And the fact is, the fact that we're having a conversation around Kansas and Montana, Georgia and South Carolina, and the fact that the Republican Party is spending tens of millions of dollars to compete in these races, which, again, for the Georgia seat, has been held by a Republican for 37 years, that is the real momentum that you're seeing on our side, that progress is being made. We have to remind ourselves of the successes that have been happening thus far. Look at what happened in Delaware, the fact that we were able to win the seat so that we can hold on the state Senate, the progress that we're seeing in terms of historic turnout in New Jersey and Virginia as we get ready for those gubernatorial races, the municipal races happening all across the country, states such as Iowa, where I'm in today, where they're going to have municipal races, school board races happening on this year. So, no, not at all. You know, Nancy Pelosi is a key reason why we have health care. Her leadership is the reason why we're able to have health care. There will always be family conversations within the party of ways you can make progress, but we have to be united right now. We cannot be Obama Democrats, Bernie Democrats, Hillary Democrats, third party Democrats. We have to be a united Democratic Party, because what is at stake is what's clear on today and on next Thursday. 23 million Americans will potentially lose their health care. That's why we have to be united and pushing back and calling out the Republicans that are not going to stand up for you.
You know, to be fair, it was Bernie Sanders who also said the Democratic Party has to do some soul searching. Michael, we have to leave it there, but we really appreciate your time. We want to go straight to Miami Beach now, where former President Bill Clinton